Dear friends, we Kannadigas and non-Kannadigas who live in Karnataka, we are very proud of our state. We are an educated lot. We are a cultured lot, susanskrutam. We are sensitive lot and we are truly very cosmopolitan. One of the important part of our public life is our healthcare. And we as a state have been very successful in managing our healthcare. And Bangalore is pretty well known today because of so many good private hospitals. In Bangalore, in Karnataka, today we are proud that we get patients from all over the world, not only just from poor South Asia or poor side of this Middle East, but people from United States, Germany, UK, from all over the sophisticated world also. Just 3 weeks back, we had a senior musician from Berlin, Mr. Grassi, who had come to Bangalore because of Max Müller Bhavan and Indo-German Society during the Oktoberfest to perform along with his philharmonic in Bangalore at Taj. And he developed a chest pain. He was brought at the Cunningham Road 40s Hospital. At that day, I was not in Bangalore, I was in Vienna giving a talk. And Grassi's CT scan, ECG and all the investigations showed that he had a tear inside his ascending aorta, which had spread, complex tear, spread to the arch of the aorta, had completely spoiled all the branches going to the brain, and he needed a very difficult, important surgery to stop him from dying. And my teammates, at the middle of the night, on a Sunday night, everybody gathered together at one call, and they did this huge operation of 8 hours, repaired and reconstructed the ascending aorta, arch of aorta, repaired all the blood vessels going to the brain, retained his original God-given heart valve. I came back, I met him, I was so pleased. 10th day after the operation, we put Mr. Grassi on a Lufthansa flight to Munich. I called my friends in Munich Heart Center. He was scanned and they called me and told me that the scan was perfect. They immediately discharged him for a rehabilitation. The picture that you see is Mr. Grassi, his brother-in-law from Dresden, and at the time of his discharge, before he said bye to us. So we have come there. But as I see around me, something is not good. Something sinister, something dangerous is happening to healthcare in Karnataka because of uninformed actions that the government is taking today. The action is called KPMEA Act, Karnataka Private Medical Establishment Act. This is an act which I wouldn't have been surprised if it was passed in North Korea, not in a sophisticated state like ours. What does this act say? This act says that this act is applicable only to the private doctors of Karnataka. The government doctors, whatever they do, this act cannot touch them. Two, if the private doctor, a patient dies with him, he's not supposed to charge, not supposed to wait for any fees to be collected and just let the whole thing go. That is not correct. Two, if the patient not doing well, patient has some complication, patient can appeal to a new body at the district level called district appellate. The district appellate is chaired by the CEO of the Jilla Parishad. Its members are all politicians and low-level bureaucrats at the Jilla level. There is no public health expert in that, but there is an Ayush doctor who has no idea about how to run a modern medicine establishment and who is actually cynical and vengeful towards modern medicine. And these people together are supposed to try that doctor. And the doctor is not supposed to represent himself through a lawyer, but he's supposed to go by himself and no lawyer. That means these people will jeer at him, will humiliate him. He has to tolerate that. But that is okay. Beyond that, this appellate authority has a power to fine him up to 5 lakhs. But what is worst is they can jail him up to 5 years. A patient who comes to the doctor wants to kill him. And if doctor goes wrong today, is India so backward that we have no laws? There are so many authorities to take care of the doctor's mistake. A, the patient can file a civil lawsuit. B, the patient can go to consumer court. The consumer court, the expenditure will be zero paisa. And The patient can even file a criminal lawsuit. The patient can go to the Karnataka Medical Council. The patient can go then to Indian Medical Council. The patient family can go to the Human Rights Commission of India. 7 bodies are there. If somebody murders somebody, the murderer will be tried by only one authority, the criminal law and criminal court of this country. Now, on this background, suddenly we have some Brihaspatis, some supervised people in our state, who say that we'll create another body, appellate body. And these kind of people who will be A, cynical, B, who would really not have much morals, ethics, and they can create a havoc. And what will happen at the tier 2 and tier 3 towns of Karnataka? A Hapta Raj will start with the doctors. And nobody can afford then to run private medical establishment, because at a district level, a guy studies hard for 20 years, develops his good sense of practice, and then comes and establishes a nursing home. Do you know how costly the land is today? On top of that, he has to construct a building. How difficult and how costly the construction is. And when he is doing that, to get his clearances, he has to go to 44 government bodies. Everybody will take their pound of flesh and money. On top of that, there are no concessions. Do you know, for industry, the electricity is charged at 80 paisa. For medical establishment, it charged more than 120 paisa. At every level, you are levied taxes. If you are paying a bill at a hospital counter, 100 rupees, do you know, 25 rupees out of that go to the government. That means more you fall sick, more you have healthcare miseries, more government will earn. This is also unfair. So A, we are not giving any help to the private people to do the healthcare establishments. We are not giving them any concessions. We are not able to give good treatment to the people, because nobody, not even a poor patient, want to go to the government hospitals. They all want to go to private hospitals because they have trust on the private hospitals. And on top of that, you want to demoralize them thoroughly like this. All these medical establishments at town 2 and town 3 levels of Karnataka are going to vanish if this act comes in the picture. Then everybody will be forced to go to government. Is the government capable of taking care of that? And then these big hospitals in Bangalore are all owned by multi-state corporations. For some time, the corporations will vanish, and then they will vanish from Karnataka. Just imagine this brilliant success story that we have built in Karnataka. What will happen? And for what? Just because the election at the corner, you want to create some emotions, you want to create some populist whip sentiments, drive a wedge between private and public, and divert the attention from what is going on. Do you know how you judge the healthcare success of a state? You judge it by maternal mortality. Do you know that our maternal mortality rate, infant mortality rate, the doctor's density per 1 lakh population, doctor's density per 100 square kilometers, in all these parameters, we are far lowest behind all the states in South India. Kerala is number one, then Maharashtra, then Andhra Pradesh, then Tamil Nadu. Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, between 2007 and 2013, their scoring, they retained. The Kerala went above. The Tamil Nadu retained, and Andhra and Maharashtra went ahead. And we are the only state which have dipped. Go to any district place, any taluka place, look at the government hospitals. Leaking walls, arrogant servants, people just like how they are scared of police, they are scared of these servants in government hospital also. Doctors missing, 40% of the specialist posts are missing. You know what is the reliability of the treatment that you will get there. And if something goes wrong with you there, government says that you cannot appeal against that. How is this fair? So, what's the point? What has to be done? How does Karnataka maintain its position and also go ahead? First, stop all these foolishness, please. This is foolish and draconian. Stop this. Election, to fight election, there are so many things one can do. Don't flirt with something as delicate and dangerous like this. Number two, have vision. whether this government, same Congress party comes back again and another government, have a vision, think big, think of taking Bangalore ahead of this, and have a healthy, wise public-private partnership. Discuss with brilliant people. There are brilliant people in private sector. Devi Shetty is there, I am there, Sudarshan Bera is there, K.N. Manjunath, C.N. Manjunath is sitting in Jayadeva. There are so many brilliant, brilliant people. Shekhar Patil is there, Sharan Patil is there. There are so many brilliant people. We can all sit together. The government authorities can sit with us. We can chart out something more healthy, something bright, brilliant, and we can chart a visionary course for the government. And we cannot say that a 7-star hotel that is opened in Bangalore and a roadside vendor should charge the same. Then we all will do the same thing that West Bengal did. That Calcutta, which was the bright spot of this country, they smashed it to lowest. Do you want to do that to Karnataka? Do you want to do that to Bangalore? No, that's not right. So what doctors are struggling, why doctors are on strike, don't look at the doctors with a low idea. What is going being talked about is wrong. Doctors are doing a good job. There are bad judges, corrupt judges. There are bad, corrupt religious preachers. There are bad lawyers. There are bad engineers, corrupt engineers. The same way there can be some bad, corrupt doctors. Does that mean with the same black brush you paint all the doctors? We are talking so bad about MCI. Do you know that after Modi has come, the MCI is so different? 60-65% people, I'm in MCI, 60-65% doctors in MCI are like me. But we have such a wrong idea because of the media, because of what they are talking in parliament, what they are talking about in assembly. So A, do not paint all the doctors with the same black brush. B, have vision, have a brilliant public-private partnership. We have to take Karnataka far ahead. We have to leave rest of India behind us. And this Draconian Act should not come in at all. It should not be even tabled in assembly, number one. Number two, there are enough authorities and enough laws already established, enough ways are established to discipline if the doctors err, and if the doctor is negligent, or if the doctor is having less knowledge. There are ways and means to judge that already. We have the laws. And to cap the prices, we can sit down and we can discuss on that. We can make some sensible suggestions. But this is a market economy. Somebody wants, he can go to nursing home. Somebody wants, he can go. Somebody, you know, there are different tiers of establishments. They can go. But if you say that you only charge this much, do you know that MRI, you said blanket charges. There's a 0.3 Tesla machine and there's a 3 Tesla machine. They both are supposed to be different things. That will cost, the cost is to the sky. This cost is to the ground. That 3 Tesla machine will close. And everybody will try to do their work of neurosurgery, cardiac surgery, all kind of complex surgeries with this 0.3 Tesla machine. Do you know what you will get? For peanut, you get monkeys. So don't do that. Leave it to the professionals. And what is happening is terribly, terribly wrong. It has to be stopped immediately there.